Hey beautiful, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Samantha aka Miss LG, and today I'm doing a full face first impressions video. That's right girl, that means eyebrows, concealer, foundation, setting powder, literally everything is new. I can't wait to get into this video. Make sure you keep on watching. I'm gonna start off by cleansing my face with the Neutrogena Hydro Boost Cleanser. Apply with a cotton pad over face, eyes and lips. No need to rinse. Here I was ready with my bowl of water to wash my face. Oh, this smells good, y'all. I feel like my face is so clean and refreshed. It just feels good. It's so gentle on the skin. It's not harsh. It smells absolutely incredible. Oh, my face feels so good. Let me just show you quickly what I have with me. I have these beautiful rose gold and black brushes. These brushes look absolutely beautiful. You know when something looks so good, it looks so pretty, you do not want to use it? That's how I feel about these brushes. Listen, these are the only things that I didn't purchase myself. I was given this during Christmas. Up until now, I haven't used them for the purpose of this video. It's serious, guys. I've also got the Morphe Dare to Create 39A palette. This palette is huge and it looks absolutely beautiful. And then I've got this box full of new makeup. Oh, I really can't wait to use this stuff, you guys. Next up, I'm gonna apply this e.l.f. lip scrub just before I actually start my makeup. So I need to dampen my lips first. It doesn't seem to have the exfoliating particles in it, but it does really moisturize my lips and I quite like that about it, and obviously it does smell and taste good, so yeah. It says when finished use a moist cotton pad to wipe it off, but I'm gonna leave it on here for a little bit longer. I don't know, I just feel like doing so. And then I do some more makeup and then I take it off and apply the lip balm. I actually have like 3 primers. I went ham on primers. I just wanted to try everything. I'm gonna start with the Bobbi Brown moisturizing face base. Guys, can you believe I spent £10 on 15ml of moisturizer? When this arrived, I was shook at how small it is. I wasn't ready for £10. Guys, don't at me, okay? I'm trying to find an alternative to the Boots Vitamin E Moisture Day Cream. This is my absolute favorite and it's so affordable. But the fact that they have discontinued this product, I'm actually trying quite a number of moisturizers to see something that would be very similar to this. This, however, is on the higher end price. The bigger one cost about, I think, £45, and I'm not ready to spend £45, child. I'm not ready, so I'm just going to apply this. It smells like lemon. Is it lemon? Yeah. It smells like lemon and citrus, I think. It definitely smells like lemon. A lot of lemons. In my opinion, anyways. Okay, it sits nicely on my skin. It feels moisturizing. Yeah, it really does feel moisturizing and hydrating. Oh, I like this. Ooh. But listen, £10 for 15ml? You better be kidding me. My face feels so plump. I'm really liking this stuff. My skin elasticity looks so good. It feels so good, so yeah, I'm down for this. For eyebrows, I bought the Essence Brow Gel. This is in the color, 01 Brown. And I also got the Essence Make Me Brow Eyebrow Gel Mascara. It's actually appearing to be black, gray black. Oh boy. Oh boy. guys, no. No. I'm gonna try the Make Me Brow Gel Mascara. So it seems to be making my brows appear a little bit more fuller, which I like. Okay, I'm gonna wipe off my brows and use my regular brow pencil. To carve my brows, I'm gonna be going in with the Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define Concealer. This is in the shade C13. I only bought C13 and C14, but I'm not sure if C13 is going to be light enough for me to highlight. I don't know, we're gonna see. This is darker than what I would normally use. It will probably be perfect for the top of my brows, just not the bottom of my brows. It is very full coverage, I've noticed for my brows already, and I quite like it actually. So far, I actually really like the eyebrow gel. I think it's actually making a massive difference to my brows, making them look a little bit more fuller. So I'm actually loving this stuff, so that's a win. So I often use the Rimmel Stay Matte Primer on my eyelids to stop the creasing. So I'm gonna be going in with the Silky Smooth Mattifying Primer, Smoothing Light Reflecting Primer from Kiss. It does two things, apparently. It mattifies and it also smooths and reflects light. Okay, let's go ahead. Oh my god, it has that silicone feel that I hate, and it's just disappearing into the skin. As much as I don't like the silicone feel, my eyelids feel quite nice. However, they feel a little bit like I've applied Vaseline on them, like that smooth texture, so I'm not sure it's going to actually mattify my eyelids. It was probably a bad idea to put this on my eyelids. I'll leave this on for a little bit and see if it dries down to a matte finish, because it does claim to be matte at the same time, so I'm gonna leave it on for a little bit. I'm gonna apply the Avian Facial Spray on the perimeters of my face. It doesn't seem to have a smell. It's literally water. I paid for water. Wow. Oh, that's quite refreshing. Obviously, it is water. I actually paid for water, guys. I don't know who I think I am, but I paid for water. This is a 300ml bottle, by the way, so it's huge. It's huge. My hair's got water in it now. Is this gonna dry down or what? Whilst my face is getting in some hydration, I'm going to apply the Makeup Revolution concealer once again on my eyelids just to prime them. Are my eyes twitching? I'm gonna go in with the Innisfree No Sebum Mineral Powder. This is a Korean brand, because I don't want to be oily. Wow, it smells strong. It smells like herbs. Wow, I like those. I really could use this all over my face, because it doesn't seem to give me that white cast, which I'm trying to avoid. So far, so good. The water has sunk into my face. I don't think I'm gonna be applying this mattifying primer on my T-zone area, because it really didn't mattify my eyelids. I'm gonna start one eye and then I'll come back and do the other eye on camera, because I'm not actually sure what I'm going to do to my eyes. It's actually my first time trying the floating wing, and I think it actually went pretty well. Sculpt, Evolve, Stroke, and Mask. These are the eyeshadows I applied on my crease and the outer corner of my eyes. And then I'm gonna go in with the red shade that is nudged. Yeah. I'm using Evolve to just deepen up that color a little bit. I'm going in with Stroke to deepen up my crease and my outer crease. This is the All Over Shadow Brush from the Beauty Professional Brush set that I'm trying out today. The brushes are quite soft and they blend nicely. I would say that I like the build on them, that it's so different. They're a little bit fat and then they get a little bit thinner as they go to the bottom, and then they have a pointy bottom. They just seem fancy. They are so thin though that you feel like it's just about to slip from your hands, but I like the whole design and the whole aesthetic of the brush. Going back in with the first brush, and I'm just going to blend the edges out just to soften the colors up a little bit. To cut the crease, I use this Beauty Professional from the brush set that I have, the Precision Shader Brush. The brush itself is angled, I don't know if you can see. So what I did, I just applied the concealer on my lower lid and then I look up. So this is a guide to where I want to cut the crease. It's as if my eyes are trying to water, but they're not really trying to water, I don't know. The eyeshadow was applying a little bit patchy, I'm not sure if you can see that. I reckon if it wasn't for the patchiness, the eyeshadow would be a little bit more brighter, because when I swatched it, it looked so beautiful. I'm gonna go back in with Snatched, the red shimmery eyeshadow from the Morphe X9A palette. I'm going back into Stroke eyeshadow, which is the second last deeper brown shade, and I'm using the All Over shadow brush once again. This is just to deepen the outer corner and just to blend it inwards a little bit. Now I'm using Essence Long Lasting Eyeliner Pen in the color White 02 White, and I'm just going to do that thing I did over there. The color is a little bit more red on this side because of the red eyeshadow. I'm gonna have to try and make it look a bit similar. For my eyeliner, I'm using the Maybelline Master Precise Liquid Eyeliner. I'm taking the black shade from the Morphe X9A palette. This is called Muse, and I'm going to just apply that on top and on the outer edge of the eye. The eyeliner, however, is quite black on its own, so you really don't need to put any black eyeshadow on top of it. I'm quite liking this brush for this area because it's being pretty precise. It's not too big, I feel like it's just the right shape. I'm not sure I'm quite feeling the white liner anymore. So, by the way, I took off my e.l.f. lip scrub and then I just put on Carmex on the mint version. For eyelashes, I have two pairs from Unicorn Lashes, and these eyelashes look so beautiful, you guys. They're not expensive either, and free delivery. I also got the Eye Charm Eyelash Glue from Unicorn Cosmetics. This was, I believe, described as the world's best glue, so I was quite curious about that. It's written in Chinese or Korean, I don't know. Whoa! Am I meant to put this on my eye? Oh my god. I'm not gonna lie, I'm scared to put this on my eyes. I really don't want to cry with these guys because their glue smells quite strong. Oh, I didn't cry, you guys. Wow. Yeah, it has that texture of when your nail glue dries on your fingers, if that makes sense. Am I making sense? I hope I'm making sense. Let it be known that our God reigns, our God saves. We lift you up, up. The eyeshadow palette, I like it. It's good. It's good blendability. However, the red shimmery shade that I tried, it does come off a little bit patchy. Maybe it's the way that I primed and prepped my eyelids. The white eyeliner, when you do apply it on top of another color, it does tend to transfer into that other color, and then it's not as white and pigmented. However, it is actually a pigmented color for the price of £2. The eyelashes, I am loving the eyelashes. I feel like they are complementing the eye look very much so well, especially with the floating wing that is not winged out. I'm loving this. I'm gonna go ahead and prime my face once again, because you can never prime your face so much, okay? You can never prep your face too much. It's never too much, right? Don't let them lie to you. So I'm using MAC Strobe Cream. This is the Hydrant Strobe Cream in Pink Light. I actually got this as a sample with my MAC order, so. I'm just gonna apply it on the perimeters of my face because I like to look hydrated. Ooh, this is pretty. Can you guys see that? When I saw this, I thought this would be good only for pale skin, for Caucasian skin, because obviously of its pinkness. But I'm actually liking this on myself. Ooh. Can you see the glow? Wow. Yes, primer. I'm just going to prime my T-zone area with the Innisfree No Sebum Mineral Powder because I really can't be having an oily face. It smells like fresh mint with something. I'm excited about foundation, guys. I am so excited about foundation. Listen, we are doing expensive, we are doing bougie, you guys. This is the Bobbi Brown foundation. So I spoke to the lady who works at Bobbi Brown and online, and she said my shade will be Almond 7. It feels so luxury. It has a pump. Can I get a name in somebody? Can I get a name in somebody? When you do your clients or whatever, this is very hygienic, the fact that it has a pump. So I'm really here for it. I'm actually gonna go in with the Beauty Professional Flawless Buffer brush. This brush looks so good. Is it the brush or the... No, it's definitely the foundation. The foundation smells... Okay, it seems to be drying. No, it's actually not bad. That's not a bad match. That's actually good. That's not bad, is it? I know some people apply foundation with a beauty blender. I don't do that. I find it is very long. But I'm gonna do this side with the beauty blender, just for the sake of those that like applying foundation with the beauty blender and you want to see the difference. Bobbi, she bad. This applies so beautifully. It has a minty scent to it and something else. I'm gonna be using this Real Techniques sponge. I've never used this one. I've used the small purple ones and the orange one, but I've actually never used the pink one. So I wanna see if it works the same, if it has the same effect as the orange one. The sponge itself does expand when you do wet it, and it actually feels so soft. So the foundation seems to have been applying a little bit too sheer on this side. I squeezed my Beauty Blender once again. I reckon it's because it was a little bit too damp. So now it's leaving less Beauty Blender marks. Flat top buffing brush, Root Techniques Beauty Sponge. So this is what they look like. This is good. I think the shade match is pretty good. Oh my god. The foundation definitely has a minty scent to it. It does feel like it's cooling down my face, if it makes sense. It doesn't feel like a foundation that you wear and there's you don't feel nothing at all, rather than just putting more foundation. I would say the coverage is probably medium to full coverage. You definitely can build it up. It doesn't feel heavy at all, but it just has this weird thing going on. But I love it. So I'm gonna go in with the Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define Concealer. Chicken leg. It is quite full coverage and it's quite thick, and I really like it so far. The concealer is separating a little bit on my nose here. That's not something that's new to me, because my nose area is very oily and my makeup separates at times on my nose area. So but now that I keep on dabbing it on, it looks fine. Wow, the color is actually not bad. This sponge is a little bit too long for my liking, so I'm just gonna go in with my favorite one. Okay, it's starting to crease up underneath my eyes. Oh, I don't know where that came from. Oh, that came from my sponge. My eyebrow pencil colored my sponge a little bit, so I'm just going to apply a bit more to cover that up. I'm gonna use the other side instead. Underneath my eyes, because I don't want them to be dry as Sahara Desert, so I'm not gonna use the Innisfree No Sebum. So I'm gonna use the W7 Banana Powder. This is new, so let's see how I like it. It's more of a white color, more than the Sachet Buttercup Powder. I initially wanted to get the Beauty Bakery Powder, but it's been sold out everywhere. And then I wanted to get the Wilder powder, the one that's brown, light brown beige, because my concealers are quite yellow, so I want to balance it out a little bit. But Wilder was going for like, was it £20? I wasn't ready for that. To keep my T-zone area matte, I'm gonna use the No Sebum powder. This powder is white, so I'm kind of fearing for my life right now. Wow, that's a lot of plant and mint smells. Oh, that's strong. I'm also gonna apply it on my smile lines, because your girl be smiling a lot, so. Now that we're looking a little bit crazy, I'm gonna go in with Fenty Beauty Pro Filter Foundation in the shade. Oh no, actually, let me try the Makeup Revolution C14. Hold on. It doesn't look like it would do much, but no. I'm gonna use my e.l.f. stippling brush. I've seen bare people using this stippling brush to contour, and I was like, I need to have it. What am I doing with my life? So I went and bought every brush that I've seen everyone use. The flat top brush, the stippling brush. This one, Alisa got me on it. She uses this to contour. When I use my big fan contour brush, I always hold it here so that I can properly blend my concealer, my contour. But I never actually thought about getting a short fan brush. I'm like, wait a minute, girl. What am I doing? Why didn't I think of that? This concealer doesn't seem to be doing much for my contour, so I'm gonna go in with Fenty Beauty foundation. This is in the color 460, if I'm not mistaken. Whoa, that's a lot. So I'm gonna take some from here, Sharing is Caring Lovey, and spread it on here. If you're new to my channel, I do not contour all the way around my forehead because my face is round, so if I come all the way here, I'm just making my face look even more rounder and wider. It doesn't make sense, so I like to contour right on the sides and up to my temples. Okay, this foundation dries quickly according to people, so I need to be fast with it. This brush is not bad. Whoa, that's a harsh contour. Oh my god. I went a little bit overboard with this contouring, guys. I'm gonna wipe off the excess powder with the Beauty Professional Precision Concealer Brush. It really has smoothed out my skin. Where are the pores at though? What pores? Wow, is this for real? These powders are probably not for me. This one is a little bit too beige for me, so I don't think it's balancing well for my skin tone. I went a little bit overboard with the contour, but that's because especially the foundation that I use, I think it's 460, it's very dark. I don't prefer my contour to be that sharp and that muddy, so yeah. The powder really does smooth out your skin. It makes you look like you've been photoshopped, like you have no pores or anything. It's really beautiful, but it is a little bit white, I think. Okay. Oh boy. I don't know if you can tell here, there's a concealer, and then here there's separation, like the concealer came off. Here there's a big blob of separation. And then everywhere else there's concealer. I don't know if you can tell. Let me try to zoom you guys in. Boy. I'm not too sure, guys. So I'm gonna take MAC Mineral Light Skin Finish in Dark Deep and just apply that all over my face, because I feel like I look so pale right now. Like, it's... So it doesn't look so bad now that I've applied my MAC Mineral Light Skin Finish, but you can still see the patchiness when you do come a little bit closer. You can still see the patchiness and the separation here. If it was the concealer, I kept building it up and then I blended it in again and it looked fine. So I'm not sure whether it's the concealer or the W7 Banana Powder. I don't know. But with the MAC Mineral Light Skin Finish now, it looks alright. But I just want to spray my face to get rid of this powdery, white-ish look going on. So, firstly, I'm going to apply, I'm so excited, Maybelline Master Chrome Highlighter. This is in Molten Gold. matte blush. This is in Bury Me App, and this is what it looks like. It looked a little bit more on the mauve side online than it actually does. It actually looks quite pink in reality. It has a lot of kickback. I don't really wear blushes, and when I do, I like them to look more of on the mauve side. So, oh wow, it's quite pink. I'm gonna spray my face with the Avian water spray. It feels like a nice mist. Yeah, I like this. I'm gonna go in with Fenty Beauty Unscented Stunner Lip Paint. This applicator, y'all. This isn't red, okay? So this is the final look. I went ahead and applied a bit more of the Essence White eyeliner, and it actually is more white, better than it was before. The red eyeshadow looks less red when you pair it with this Fenty Beauty lipstick, because this lipstick is pure red. But yeah. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed filming it. I'm actually quite happy with how the look came out in the end, considering there were some flops and some L's along the way. I'm loving the look, I'm loving the colors, I'm literally loving everything about it. If I do say so myself, I think it looks so good.